Murphy's Law. The idea that anything that can go wrong will go wrong. Occurrences, circumstances, happenings and such that just aren't good. Good. Now, let's say your life is a house. Beautiful and big, choice colors and landscape to perfection. We all know that the strength and the longevity of the house is based on the solidity of its foundation, which poses necessary questions. Is your house wisely built? Can it stand against the beating of descending rains, rushing floods, or boisterous winds? Or will it greatly fall?
Likes on the gram today?
Ha ha!
See, Instagram popping on that thing.
My Father, Lord, I ain't even talk to you today. Thank you for this day. Thank you for protection. I love you. Amen. Oh, shoot, I'm finna be late. Oh, man.
Man, I can't believe this. They took my J's, my Louis Shades, my chain. God, what is this day? Like, am I being punished for not going to church or something?
Oh, I gotta go. I'm gonna be late for work.
Insufficient funds. I know you lying. Wyoming ain't never been to Wyoming. My whole account is at zero. What is going on today?
Hey, Dre. I checked my horoscope this morning and it said I'm supposed to find love. Remember that cute guy in the office I was telling you about? Maybe he's my love interest. What's going on with you today?
Not today, Tamia. I got a lot going on
today. I mean, you walk around here like you're going through a midlife crisis. You pouting. It's really throwing off my energy.
Hello?
Hey, this is Nurse Maya calling from Right Way Medical Center. May I speak with Mr. Mitchell, please?
Yes, this is he.
Hey, so we got your results back, and we're looking to schedule you an appointment to come back and see us to talk over a few things.
Doctor said I should be good. Is everything all right?
I'd love to see what days work best for you so we can schedule you an appointment.
I'm not coming in for no appointment. I'm not coming in for that. None of that. I'm good.
Sorry, sir.
Man, I'm really gonna die. I'm really gonna die. Lord, I thought you said you weren't gonna put on more of me than I can bear, or whatever the scriptures say, Lord. You know what I'm talking about. Take this cup from me.
Take this cup from me? Are you serious? Speaking of cup, come on, let's go get us something to drink. This cup, come on. Okay, so what's going on with you today?
This is it. I'm really about to die. The doctor just called and told me that.
Wait, die? What did they say?
So I went in for a checkup. Doctor ran some tests, said I should be good. But now they calling me back, so it's gotta be bad, right?
Well, yeah, that don't sound too good. You know, my auntie, she eats pork and drinks Cokes the same way you do. You know, they called her in for a checkup. Turns out, she checked out. She died. Rest in peace. Maybe now you'll listen to me when I talk.
Like, why would you tell me that? I just don't understand. I'm a good person, I treat people right. Like, why is this happening to me?
You know what they say, good people die first. They should know you're a good person.
Huh? You're not helping at all.
I don't know what to tell you. Wait, actually I do. I have these healing crystals. I use them when I pray. Let me go grab them for you right quick.
You know those crystals aren't going to do anything for you, right?
At this point, I need anything. They broke into my car today. Somebody hacked into my account. All my money is gone. Now the doctor's calling me. Now I'm about to die.
Wait. Aren't you a Christian?
Yeah, I am, but what God at in all this? And who are you? I don't remember us being cool at that.
I'm at kind of new here, kind of not, but that really doesn't matter.
Yeah, it kind of does.
You told me about your day, so why don't you just show me?
Not a nice place. Also, you might want to get some milk. I kind of used it for my cereal. But I told you, I want you to show me your day so I can show you how to respond with some faith.
Mr. Man of God, about to pray with some little rocks. Like, you clearly have lost your mind because that's wild.
How did you get in? Like, how did you get in? Did you Thanos snap or something?
Tick-tock.
You gotta get to work, and you're asking a lot of questions. So, we're at the beginning. So, what happened this morning?
Okay, well, I was getting ready for work, eating my cereal. I was on the gram, I was popping today. I had like 800 likes on that thing today. I was popping.
So, you mean to tell me, the first thing you did this morning was feed yourself and your ego?
Oh, I ain't saying all that now. I threw up a quick prayer.
So, you didn't spend any time with God this morning? You didn't read the word or confess anything over your life?
Well, yeah. I thanked him for this day and I thanked him for protection.
A quick prayer?
A quick prayer? Boy, you are not three anymore. Just like you get dressed naturally, you need to take some time to get dressed spiritually. Just saying a quick prayer is not going to have you equipped for the day. Yeah. Read this. Ain't read this in a while. A little dusty. Come on. Read out loud. Let's go.
Dear God, I thank you for this today.
Dear God, I thank you. Boy, say it with some confidence. Come on. Sit up straight. Come on. Say it with your chest.
Dear God, I thank you for this today that you have made, and I will rejoice and be glad.
See? You didn't even command your day right. You walking out this door every day, naked and afraid. We gotta put your spiritual clothes on. Gotta grab your helmet, your hip.
Yo, what you doing? They finna run off with all my stuff.
I thought we just established that we're gonna start doing things the right way.
Yeah, I'm about to go handle these dudes the right way. What you mean?
Look, come on. Okay, so what did you do at this moment?
Hey!
Okay, that's it?
Then I went to the car, seen that all my things was gone. I tried to call the cops, but by the time they was gonna get out, I was gonna be late for work.
Okay, show me.
See, they took everything, man. They took my J's, my shades, my sweatshirt, my chain. I don't believe this. Mm-hmm. My Louis shades gone.
Check the middle console.
The middle console? Yo, I forgot I put $20 in here.
But I thought they took everything.
They did. You just seen them run off with everything.
You're missing it. Yes, they may have taken your stuff, but those are just materialistic things. They can be rebought and replaced. Can't you see that you're even blessed to have a car to rob? A beautiful roof over your head and breath in your lungs? And a father who can replace all the things on demand and then some? You're not seeing this right. It's all about the perspective.
All right. You right. They may not have taken everything, but in just a few seconds, we're about to find out that they took everything, like all my money from my account.
No, for real. All your money. Not all your money.
Stop playing, I'm for real.
Dang, they took your money. That's kind of tough. Lighten up. See, you're letting this thing defeat you. What happened to God supplying all your needs? What happened to God being your provider? What happened to him restoring everything and then some? Where's your trust in Christ at? Because based off your response, it clearly shows where your trust lies. And it's more in getting the money and getting it back than it is in the one who's truly supplying it. Yes, what has happened may not be ideal, but you still have to have trust.
Yo, it's the doctor's office. They about to give me some bad news.
Hold up. So you mean to tell me the last time they told you that you were about to die?
Well, no, but why else would the doctor's office call you back? It's gotta be bad, right?
How do you even know that? You don't. You went in for a checkup. A checkup is supposed to tell you what's going on the inside of your body. So yes, you may not know what they're gonna say, but that's okay. You don't go to the appointment in fear. You go to the appointment in faith. Last time, you took on a whole sickness that they never even told you that you had. Like, what you do, use Google or WebMD and became a doctor overnight? Now, we talked about your responses. So let's see how you handle this one. Now, answer the phone before it stops ringing.
Hello?
Hi, this is Nurse Maya calling from Right Way Medical Center. May I speak with Mr. Mitchell?
Yes, this is he.
Hey, so we got your results back from the lab, and we're going to schedule you an appointment to discuss your results and do some further testing.
Okay, sounds good.
Awesome, how does Thursday at 2 p.m. sound?
Yeah, that works.
Okay, great. See you then. Have a great day.
Okay. So what now? All I did was just agree to an appointment.
We just talked about this. Now you pray and declare some scripture over your life and receive the healing that is already yours. You don't fear or worry, but you use the power that you have in Christ and you stand firm on that, that's what's next.
This is just too much. Like, am I missing something? Like, am I doing something wrong? Like, why God punishing me for all this?
This is not about being right or wrong.
Then what is it about?
It's about being. Because newsflash, Andre, God is not concerned about your actions or trying to punish you for anything that you have done. Because in his eyes, you have already been made right with him. In Christ, you are fearfully and wonderfully made. Your issue and the point of all of this is to show you that your foundation in him is what's messed up. You're so worried about popping on the gram, getting 800 likes, worried about what he say and she say, what society has to say about this thing and that thing, and then have the nerve to put God second on the back burner. And at the first moment that any trouble comes up, you run to go pray to some false gods with some rocks. But guess what, Mr. Andre? The reality is, life is going to happen. Just like it's sunny one day, storms are going to come, and problems will be thrown at you. But as a believer, you know, the one that you claim to be, you have to be firmly rooted, 10 toes down. Not one, not two, not that big toe, and definitely not that pinky toe, but 10 toes down in faith and operate from that place. As opposed to operating from a place of fear, worry, and doubt. Because in Christ, and this is so vitally important for you to get together, there is promise, there's prosperity, there's perseverance, and there's protection. And you have to believe that no matter what happens or comes your way, that you are protected. Because his word says that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. And his word is always true. That, Mr. Andre, is the foundation you need to strengthen.
So what now?
You pray, confess the word, and believe.
How about you just pray for me then?
I see you're still trying to take the easy way out, huh? But no, I can't do that for you. This is not my journey. This is yours. You have to take the first step to seek him. I can't do it for you, but I can't be here with you.
Lord, I thank you. I need your help right now, God. It's been a bad day. I don't know what I'm doing, God.
Rebuild. To repair, especially to dismantle and reassemble with new parts. To replace, re-strengthen, or reinforce. You may ask, how can I rebuild my foundation? It can be as simple as your response. Respond to life's inclement weather with the voice of a conqueror. It's your rebirth right. And as a believer, being in Christ, you are endowed with the power of the one true victorious God. Command it. Confess it. This won't always negate the reality of bad things happening, but we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the words of our testimony. Don't stumble or fall through the tough times. Be preserved, because we serve a God who overcame both death and the law, even Murphy.
Lord, I'm trying to get my foundation back right with you, Lord. And I just need your help, Lord, to help me walk this thing out.
What are you doing? Are there bugs on you? Yeah, you tripping. You need these bags. Come on.
I'm good on them. I'm going to my office.
They work. Take them. Just take them.
I'm good on them.
They work.
They don't. I know what's up,
man. They really work.
I'm good.
Just take them.
La, 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 la.